Hello and welcome back to Pole Talk with Lebowsplitz, where I talk about everything related to pole dance training and performing. Today I want to talk about something that is very common with performing, and that is stage anxiety, stage fright, that all those like really nervous feelings you get before you're about to go on stage and perform something that you've either prepared or not prepared. So for us as pole dancers, we are half naked most of the time, and we are putting on a performance for a large audience, or maybe not that many people. It takes a lot of guts to do that, and it is a very vulnerable thing to be doing. And so it is natural to feel all the feelings that you feel when you go on stage, before you go on stage, even just thinking about going on stage, which is a stage fright kind of feeling. I still get these feelings before I go on stage and perform, but these are kind of okay to have. That is because if you didn't feel them, then you wouldn't get the endorphins to be able to do the thing that you're about to do. And it also means that you care. So if you're feeling these things, don't be afraid. They say that like when you have butterflies, just make sure you channel them in the right direction. And I think that applies especially for this. Because since we are doing things that often require memory, as far as like doing a sequence or a certain routine that you have prepared, you don't want to forget in the middle of the performance, which I have done. So I'm going to give you tips that I have that have helped me getting on stage, performing, and making it look like I wasn't afraid at all. If you get anything out of this video, please let me know, leave a comment, leave a like. This video is going to be especially helpful if you are planning a performance, if you've never performed before, or if you are a performer and still struggle with performing on stage. This is also helpful if you are doing a pole competition or are a pole competitor. I also want to preface that performing to me is a very special thing. It is a unique moment for you to share your story and to express yourself the way you want. The worst thing that can happen is that you get in your own way of your performance and you aren't able to deliver what you know you're capable of. And that usually happens because the brain is taking over and you're not letting your body and your training do its thing. So this is my approach for what has helped me, and I hope it helps you as well. So my first tip is going to be pretty obvious, but I think it's an important one to state, and that is preparation. There's obviously two kinds of performances. One where you have something planned that you're going to do, and one where you're just freestyling. I think it's possible to prepare in both ways. Having a routine already set, you're going to want to prepare and do that routine as far in advance as possible, as many times as possible, and in different contexts. So in front of people, maybe like a rehearsal, by yourself, which you'll obviously do the most, in front of a mirror, not in front of a mirror. This can be its own whole series because there's so much you can do to prepare for the moment when you present that routine. If you have a routine prepared, I would suggest doing that like at least 10 times on its own. You can visualize it, you can run through it in your mind. The individual tricks you should feel really good about on their own. I would not suggest doing anything that you don't feel confident doing. The stage is not the place to try crazy tricks that you've never done before. I hope that goes without saying. If it's a freestyle performance, it's kind of the same thing. You still want to do things that you've already done before and that you're comfortable with. Don't start throwing in a bunch of things that you're unsure about, because I mean, the chances that it's going to go well are kind of slim. Kind of come up with some sequences that you know and are familiar with. You always want to draw from stuff that you already feel good about. So if it's going to be a performance with like one shot deal, you want to look good for that one song or whatever time you have on stage. I would recommend having like kind of a list of things, tricks, moves, things you do that are uniquely you, or tricks that you feel really confident with. I personally have like written down performance sequences and combos that I feel very comfortable with. And it's always kind of like in my mind, like, oh, I know I'm good at like X, Y, and Z, so that like if something doesn't go well, or if I have no ideas popping up for what to do next, it's almost like my body already knows what to do because it's done this like Allegra so many times. It just like naturally falls into that. One time I did a pole competition where I was in the middle of my spin pass and I forgot what I was doing next. I had this very like deer in the headlights moment. I was on the pole two climbs up and I was supposed to do a bird of paradise. and I just forgot where I was. It was bright, the lights were in my eyes, and I was like, and so instead, like, before I could even really consciously think about it, as I was inverting, my body's like, okay, let's do Allegra. So I ended up doing Allegra instead and just like drawing my arm out for like the lyric of the song, and it actually turned out pretty well, but I would consider myself lucky and prepared in a different way for that moment. So that's just an example of like being prepared in other, like kind of like a plan B situation. So you want to be as prepared as possible with what you have planned and what you don't have planned. You can also be prepared by having like things in the back of your head, sequences, combos, tricks. This is kind of a side tip that goes along with being prepared physically, is preparing for the performance in terms of like your aesthetic, like your makeup, your hair, your outfit, having a backup outfit. These are things that you don't really think about, but then when it comes down to like the actual performance day, if you don't have these things already planned, they end up taking up more time than you realize. And you end up having to rush, basically, and then you don't want to bring that rush energy to your performance. So if you want to be extra prepared, you could do your makeup and hair as like a rehearsal in advance, like before the day of the performance, especially if you have a very unique look that you're taking to the stage that you've never done before. Like, for example, one time I did like this lipstick with like black on the outside and red on the inside, and I've never done that before because I never really experimented with makeup. I had to practice that several times before I did it on the day of the performance. And same with my Britney Oops I Did It Again performance. I had to learn how to do my hair like Britney via my hairstylist, and then also I had to research the makeup look and practice it so that it looked good. Especially when you have a performance that you've been preparing for like months, you don't want to be spending the day of the performance trying to figure out how to make the look match the performance. So do that stuff in advance. You will not regret it. Having these things prepared is going to help you feel more confident on the day of the performance rather than worrying, especially when you're in the middle of throwing on all your makeup and say, oh, that doesn't look good. You know, like you just want everything to go as smooth as possible. So being prepared is the first thing you can do. Visualization is also a part of being prepared. Make sure that you think about the day of your performance from morning to night, even the night before. Plan out your meals, think about how much water you need to be drinking. The most important is like visualizing the actual performance from start to finish, because a lot of things could happen. Like, you don't know, like the day of the performance, maybe your dog gets sick, like maybe you get a flat tire. There's a lot of things that could go wrong, but when it comes to you being on the stage, that you can like have control of. So in my brain, I always think like, plan it from the moment they call your name, or not call your name, but the moment you step on the stage until the time you walk off. Don't forget, until you're all the way off the stage, it's still a performance. So thinking about your entry, what are you gonna look like? How are you gonna stand? Visualize the look that you have planned and how you're going to approach the audience. I also think about like what feelings I want to evoke, depending on the performance, like what kind of piece it is and what do I want the audience to feel. Having all of this will just help the performance be better, but it'll also kind of clarify things in your mind for like how you want it to go. If you have a song for the performance, then play it over on repeat in your head. Like, you could do this weeks before the performance, have it on auto repeat and close your eyes and think about yourself doing all the things perfectly when you're on stage. So a tip for when you're about to go on stage, you obviously want to talk to yourself in a very good way. You want to have positive self-talk, not be like, I'm the worst performer ever. Like, those moments right before you go on stage are critical and they can be the biggest mindfuck. Like, some people like to be completely in their zone, not talking to anyone. And some people want to distract themselves from their brain. They're running like thoughts. Both things are okay, but overall you want to have a positive conversation happening in your head. As you're having that positive self-talk dialogue, you can also think about like previous performances that you've done, previous successes that you've had, and just your training in general, and remind yourself that you are prepared and that you got it. You can remind yourself that fuck-ups may happen, because this is a normal part of a live performance. If things don't go according to plan, it's not the worst thing in the world. And people know that things happen. And even if something does happen, like, you're gonna recover and you're gonna learn from it. Like, I think people have put like tons of pressure on themselves to have like the perfect performance, and it's just not going to happen. So you might as well just accept it. That's also what makes performing kind of exciting. If you think about it, it's not a produced, edited moment. It is just raw and real, and whatever happens, happens. So if you fuck up, just know it's okay and you can learn from the experiences for next time. And then just, you know, gathering all those experiences is going to make you a better performer every next performance that you do. You can also think about it like, if you don't do this next performance, are you going to regret it? Like, if you're on your deathbed, what are you going to feel if you didn't end up doing it? I like to think about that myself, because there's that feeling of like, oh, maybe I'll just back out because I'm so nervous, but you probably will regret it. There's obviously the very natural feeling of not wanting to be judged or criticized while you're on stage, and that is just a normal part of performing. If you're going to be in the spotlight, you kind of are being judged, and I think you just kind of have to be okay with that. Everyone is different. Not everyone will like you, and you kind of have to go at it like, if they like me, they like me, and if they don't, they don't. Everyone's on a journey, and you just have to meet yourself with where you're at. Everyone wants to be accepted and loved and cheered for, and whether that happens or not, you still have yourself, you're still you, and whatever you bring onto the stage is something to be proud of, because you're not sitting on your couch watching and judging someone else. You are the person that is putting on a show, and I think that's something to be respected. So those are all the tips I have for today, and I hope they helped you. Leave a comment if you liked any one of them specifically, and please subscribe.